our animals here offer a lot of really unique behaviors throughout the course of their day. In order for us to put those on a signal, we use a training style called capturing. It's basically like taking a photograph of the moment that they do something like that vocalizing from Sierra. We reinforce it with a whole bunch of fish, wait for them to do it again, reinforce it again, and eventually put it on a signal. We're gonna show you some really cool examples of how we train that behavior, and also a lot of the behaviors that these animals have come up with over the years. So a great way that we can capture behaviors is through play training. And one of the things that we love to do with our animals, and our animals love to do with us, is to play with the hose. So this is a freshwater hose. And our animals seem to love the way it feels on their teeth and their gums. And for Sierra, who you can hear, so vocalize to our coworkers, which happens to be Kim, playing with Sierra and Tipper. And they share the hose when they're playing. And when Sierra wants it to be her turn, she tends to vocalize to give us that information. And so that vocalization is a really neat behavior. They naturally do that as a way to communicate with each other and also to communicate with us. And so utilizing this behavior that she does as part of our play training sessions, we were able to put that on the signal, and we'll show you what that sounds like in our training sessions. So the next step would be adding on a verbal or a hand signal. So as you hear Kim, she says the word talk. And then Sierra offers that behavior, and then she gets reinforced with that hose play. And then what we did after that is we transitioned it into a training session.
And now that the capturing process is finished, we can ask for Sierra's vocal behavior just like this. Now that you've learned how we capture behaviors, we'd like to show you some of the amazing behaviors that our animals naturally do, as well as some of the behaviors that they've come up with on their own.
So here we have Reggae and his trainer Kim. And Reggae is one of our male Atlantic harbor seals, and during breeding season, he exhibits a lot of really awesome behaviors as a way to call attention to himself. And so we've put all of these behaviors on signals so that we can show them off during his training sessions. Sometimes during breeding season, for our male harbor seals, one way they call attention to themselves is to make really unique sounds. So here's one that Reggae does. Another one he does that's really cool, we actually mimic the sound and he does it back. And this one's called Raspberry. Other things that are really fun that Reggae has done during breeding season is showing off how good he is at blowing bubbles underwater. And he does this just by us saying the word.
Bubbles.
So this is Tara and our 4-year-old northern fur seal Luna, and Luna has a lot of energy, and sometimes when she has so much energy, she'll show off this really cool behavior that we call dance. So we would watch her do it, we would put it on a signal, and now you guys can see it looks like this. So all of that was trained through capturing, all something that Luna came up with all on her own. We were able to put it on a signal just to show off to you guys.
So one of the behaviors that our animals exhibit throughout the course of the day is this unique behavior, where they rub their whole body from head to tail. These are our two female northern fur seals. In order to better explain why they do this, we use the style of training called capturing to introduce it in our sessions.
Here is exactly what we're talking about. This is called grooming. And Katovi will do this over the course of the day in between training sessions. And basically it enables her to build up that pocket of air between her two layers of fur. And it also helps her prevent any squid or other fish juices from getting into her fur. Oftentimes guests will think that maybe she's really itchy, but it's just allowing her to stay nice and warm as a northern fur seal would do out in the wild as well. Because she does this behavior over the course of her day, in order for us to put this on a signal, we would just observe her doing this behavior after a training session, come out here and give her a whole bunch of fish, wait for her to do that behavior again, and repeat that. And now we can show it to you in training sessions so we can explain how cool northern fur seals are. Hi everybody. So we're here with Sean and Chakota, And one awesome thing that Chakotah does that's really unique is a vocalization. He is the grandson of Hoover, one of our harbor seals you may have heard of. And Chakotah vocalizes pretty frequently all on his own without even putting it on a signal. And so you oftentimes could hear him vocalizing all the way down the plaza here at New England Aquarium. So in order to put that on a signal, we would come out here, give him a whole bunch of fish anytime we heard that, and then we put it on a word. So we can say that word, and then you can hear what he sounds like. And Sean's gonna ask him so you guys can hear that at home.
Chucky, top. Chakotah.
So that's a pretty unique sound. Most of our harbor seals are fairly quiet, but Chakotah has this really awesome set of vocalizations that he offers. Thank you so much for watching our training sessions. We hope you've learned a lot about the behaviors that our animals do as part of their daily lives. Behind me are our California sea lions doing something else that they're naturally good at, relaxing. And we hope you're getting some time at home to relax as well. Once again, we thank you so much for watching, and we hope you can tune in tomorrow for our next virtual visit at 11 a.m. Bye, everybody.